Hello everybody, welcome back to some more speed paint. In this episode we're going to continue on with redesigning the Ben 10 aliens and do Ghostfreek for Halloween. So before you get too far into this, I am going to warn you before you get to the end. The final piece, at least to me personally, is a little unnerving. Well, a little more than a little unnerving is the proper... It's quite unnerving. So if you don't like really creepy things, I would strongly suggest you don't watch to the end of the video. But if you're kind of excited for some more disturbing, spooky Halloween content, then this is definitely going to be right up your alley. This is my Halloween video, even though it's a week before, because I want you guys to have some time to watch and enjoy it before the season, before spooky season is over for this year. So, but this is a little darker, both figuratively and literally, of a piece than I would have made just of my own accord. When I designed Voldemort a few weeks ago, I challenged myself to not use any line art because I just see that I've become quite reliant on it, at least in my digital art. So the real version of Ghostfreek is mostly purple. And I didn't really think that I could make that look super realistic. I mean, I'm sure I could have if I wanted to, but I went with more of a white corpse-like gaunt look that I think really fits this piece. Now there's a lot of kind of disproportional and spiky bits, like the spines going down his neck or the really, really long, just creepy fingers. So anyways, as you are probably able to start piecing together, this design is closer to the, if you know the lore of Ben 10, the true form of Ghostfreek, but it's kind of a, honestly, a mix of the original and true forms. But there are some remnants of the original form, like the eye and the lack of tentacles from the gut. So I kind of, in my head, imagine this as almost an intermediate form that I really focused a lot on the face and a lot on the way the torso looks human, but also looks as though it has some human form, but also as though it's maybe injured or just has some weird, just unearthly deformity. So, true Ghostfreek has a face that kind of or a head that kind of resembles an upside down skull. So I kind of took that quite literally. And I made it maybe a little creepier than it needed to be, but that's okay. It has these two big eyes, and this originally the mouth was going to be closed like it is in the Wikipedia art, but I thought it would just be a little more intimidating or off-putting to have the mouth be really far open. Not only because that is a really unnatural length of jaw, but also because if you look at animals, they will open their mouths or puff themselves up to make themselves more intimidating. And I just think that that achieved that same effect. As I went through the different sessions of making this, I had the sketches on my phone and just the pre-color work on my phone. And I was just messing around with filters, and I came upon this idea of almost having the composition of the piece as though like someone's shining a flashlight on it, that there'd be very harsh light on him, so that you'd see just some real weird shapes and imagery. So that my main thought process was like, okay, you're gonna see this thing with a flashlight in the middle of the night, and it's gonna be some real creepy thing. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. As much as you can enjoy something as creepy as this. Next week I will be back with another Halloween thing. It's definitely not going to be as creepy, but I don't know what it's going to be yet. It's definitely but I will see you all when we get there. Enjoy.